Good morning. I welcome you all on the behalf of SKRP Gujarati Homeopathic Medical College, Indore. I, Dr. Kushal Parakh, coordinator of today's webinar, to on the behalf of Department of Pathology and all the Homeopathic College of Indore, I welcome all the homeopathic lovers, doctors and students of homeopathy. First webinar was with Dr. UK Verma, and now today with us is Dr. Rajat Chattopadhyay sir from West Bengal, Kolkata. So coming up with this, I first of all introduce you with the today's speaker, Professor Dr. Rajat Chattopadhyay sir. He is a PhD homeopathy from West Bengal University of Health Sciences and MD homeopathy from Kolkata NIH, and he is currently as the principal of the Kolkata Homeopathic Medical College and Hospital. It is the one of the oldest homeopathic institute of Asia. He has a 25 years professional experience and author of 3 books, which is one of the book is of cardiology, which is from BGen, and others are from the IBPP. He is the resource person of CCH, CCRH and NIH. Many of the publications are in the peer reviewed journals. He is the ex-HOD of medicine, having experience of 12 years. He has presented many papers in international national level seminars, and he is the principal investigator of research project under West Bengal government, academic person in true sense, having sound knowledge, clinical knowledge of medicine and of homeopathic philosophy. He is author and also researcher and internationally famous speaker. So this is in short the brief introduction of the Dr. Rajat Chattopadhyay sir, and he will today speak on the utility of the or study of the Allen's keynote and how to use it in the daily practice. So with this, I first of all welcome Dr. S.P. Singh sir, principal homeopathic SKRP Homeopathic Medical College. Sir, please.
On behalf of our management, Sri Gujarati Samaj Indore, I myself, Professor Dr. S.P. Singh, forever learner and teacher of Ardhana of Medicine, principal of SKRP Gujarati Homeopathic Medical College, Hospital Research Center, Indore, MP. Good morning to all of you, respected participants from different places of India, as well as other foreign countries. I welcome everyone who has willingly registered for listening today's webinar. Thank you for all joining us. Today we are presenting Understanding of Allen's Keynote, Materia Medica and Daily Prescribing, presented by respected Professor Dr. Rajat Chattopadhyay, Principal, Kolkata Homeopathic Medical College and Hospital, West Bengal. Just a little housekeeping before we get started. If you have any questions during the presentation, please type them into the question box in your chat box. I will bring them during the presentation, and we will also have time for question at the end of. We will have sufficient time for questioning at the end. Once again, I appreciate all participants for joining the event. Thank you very much to all of you.
So here is with we have with us Dr. Preeti Kavtekar ma'am, HOD Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology. She will tell us, or she will brief us with today's session. Ma'am, please.
Good morning, all of you. On the behalf of SKRP Gujarati Homeopathic Medical College, I, Dr. Preeti Kavtekar, welcome Professor Dr. Raja Chattopadhyay ji. Dear respected audience and listeners, as we all know, when considering a homeopathic remedy to help with the mental and emotional symptoms, there are certain keynotes that can help to select similimum. While applying materia medica is to constantly compare and differentiate, you must compare the pathogenesis of the remedy with the recorded symptom of the patient to find out and select the similimum to this correctly. The student must have proper knowledge of the individuality of the remedy, something that in peculiar, uncommon and characteristics in the Polycrus remedy. And this may be keynote symptom. This excellent work by Dr. Allen help us to group PQRS symptoms in no time. आज हमारे बीच में डॉक्टर रजत चट्टोपाध्याय जी हैं जो हमको एलिन की नोट के बारे में समझाएंगे. और बिल्कुल भी टाइम वेस्ट ना करते हुए सर, मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करती हूँ कि आप अपने टॉपिक के ऊपर हमको इनलाइट करें. थैंक यू सर.
Allen's keynote on practice, you know, basically it is keynote prescription. And as a man from Bengal, from Kolkata, the Kolkata, most of the practitioners, they prefer since back, they prefer this Allen's keynote. And I think whatever in the scenario of Indian scenario of materia medica and all over India, the HC Allen's keynote probably more and more used, even in many cases, it may be abused by the Bengal homeopaths and the Kolkata type of practice. Whatever most of the practitioners, they are the base. They have the base on this H.C. Allen's materia medica, that the keynote based Allen's keynote materia medica. First of all, I should say that these Allen's keynote, it is not only based on keynote. If you just go through the history of these Allen's keynote, you can see the most of the symptoms that was picked up by H.C. Allen, that is from Herring's Guiding Symptom. And you know, it's a very voluminous book of Herring's Guiding Symptoms, 10 volumes, very big voluminous book. So students of the first year, second year, so they become in a fix. What to do with it? Because they usually come with +2. And whenever they will be entering into the first BHMS or then second BHMS, they will be in a fix. What to do with the vast symptomatology of the 5,000 symptomatology of phosphorus or 2,000 symptomatology of any other polycrates? So what are the PQRS? Rightly, the coordinator was telling that the PQRS rightly chosen by these HC Allen's. And I think there are many more GMs still lying with the Herring's Guiding Symptoms, but whatever he has picked up from Herring's Guiding Symptoms, all are GM. You don't think that one line, that is the Allen's keynote based on only one line. It may be one line, but if we elaborate it, if we discuss it, if we discuss it from clinical point of view, from practice of medicine point of view, if we discuss it from materia medica point of view, if we discuss it from organ and homeopathic philosophy point of view, then that one line may be pages after pages. So right now, you know, all you will agree with me that it is not possible for me to complete all the HC Allen's keynotes materia medica within this 40 minutes or 45 minutes of tenure of this webinar. It is impossible task. But that should be a beginning. So I shall convey that it is rather than sharing of my experience with the Allen's keynote, as well as there will be a little bit of guiding that what type of learning we should go through Allen's keynote. Because all the Bengals people and all the students of Calcutta, they are very much accustomed with this H.C. Allen's keynote, and they go line by line with the bracket. Because I am also product from one Bengals government college of Maheshwarcharya. Now I am in another government college of Calcutta Homeopathic Medical College. But I have seen, and I am also the student, being the student of this gharana, it is a habit for the students of Kolkata and West Bengal to go line by line, line by line. Even I know that most of the students, they can remember the lines with the brackets and the drugs within the brackets. And within these bracket drugs, they have their some type of other type of utility. I will show you. So let us start the presentation. H.C. Allen, the major works of Dr. H.C. Allen, that is the homeopathic therapeutics, so we know the intermittent fever. Another one, this is the Q-Notes, Metria Medica, the topic of today's. And Allen Bonihusen's slip card repertory, this is on 1900 and 1910, the Metria Medica of the No Sorts. All these are major works of Dr. H.C. Allen. And you can see this 1836 to 1909, and we can remember the timing of herring, sea herring, that is from 1800 to 1880. And so just after herring, Dr. H.C. Allen, also the professor and dean of the Herring Medical College of America. So he, whatever the work left by Dr. Herring, that Dr. H.C. Allen tried to complete all those works. The why I put this slide of dithyrinum first, because you can realize, you can find the what boldness Dr. H.C. Allen had at that time. At that time, he was bold enough to say, to claim that dithyrinum, the profession, is asked to put it to the test and publish the failures to the world. So how bold was that statement was? The author has used it for 25 years as a prophylactic and has never known a second case of diphtheria to occur in a family after it had been administered. Though at that time, this type of research scenario, this type of data recording, this type of documents or evidence-based medicine was not at that time, but still he claimed that 25 years he used diphtherinum and not a single case. So whenever he claimed, so he had the data of this, and he was bold enough to declare it in his own book. So this is the boldness and the genuinity of this book. Whatever written in this book, from the first line to last line, it has got tremendous impact on the daily clinical practice. So we must not think that it is a very small book. It is a very utility books in the table of the any practitioners, and the main textbook of Herring's guiding and all the TFLNs or all these copper threads, etc. Books of Metria Medica are very voluminous books, and this is very small books like Nash books, but these are not the voluminous book, but these are voluminous book from the information. The so much information is within the one line we can explain in the latter slides. So what to read? Each remedy must be read from the full name of the remedy, from the heading, and to the last line of relations, aggravation and amelioration. So what I have to say, that even if I say the first line, then if I take only the first lines of all the drugs or most of the drugs of the LNs, then this 40 minutes is too less for that. If I take the last line, I will try with the last line and relations and aggravation and amelioration, this type with 30 or 40 slides. So you can understand, you can realize the depth of this book and how wonderful, but wonderful tips. Because students and the interns and the house staffs and the very would-be doctors and the new budding doctors, they are very much fond of reads and want to know from the seniors, from the professors, from his guides, his or her guides, to know about how to practice. The hints of this practice, you can get it in numerous pages of this H.C. Allen's Metria Medica. The most important characteristic features and field of application may be found under the headings of relation, aggravation, and amelioration. Now, say for example, aboriginal. It is then the last part, aboriginal, within the relationship part, the after hypersulfur in furuncle. So we know the furuncle, we know the inflammatory process of the furuncle and the tremendous pain of furuncle. But, and very often we use hypersulfur, but whenever the pain after the hypersulfur, the pain remain, and this aboriginal may cause. Even the same thing, we can say that after aconite and bryonia in pleurisy, when pressing sensation remains in affected side, impeding respiration, that means you know the symptoms of the pleuritis, you know the symptoms of the dry pleurisy, the typical stitching pain on the left side like bryonia, whatever the characteristic symptom of bryonia. So bryonia or aconite can produce the symptoms of pleuritis, that it doesn't mean that the aconite and bryonia are the only remedy for the pleurisy. The symptoms of the pleurisy, which is the common symptom of pleurisy, that is the stitching pain, and that the stitching pen is very much sensitive. This type of stitching pen may be seen in aconite and bryonia, both the drugs. And whenever these aconite and bryonia has already completed their work, then if the pressing sensation remains in the particular affected lesion site, then we can use of abrotenone. Like after hypersulfur in furuncle, like after aconite and bryonia in pleurisy. So it is not written in the text, but in the main part of abrotenone, but it is written in the relationship part. Just like amoncord, it antidotes the poisoning with rustax, rust, and sting of insects. So usually whenever it comes with the poisoning of rustax, we usually give rustax and all other Apis mellifica like medicines. But amoncord has the capability to antidote the poisoning of rust and sting of insects. And what is important here, one small line that is affects the right side most. We know the affect the right side most is Lycopodium. We know the affect right side most is the Podophyllum, like that. But in amoncord, with the relationship part, the affects the right side most. And inimical to lachesis, it is very common to the relationship part. But what I am just want to emphasize here, just don't think that the main text part from the first before relationship is the main part. Within the relationship, there are very many clues, there are very many tips which can be used in daily practice. And I will show from A to Z you only on those parts, because today's webinar may be concentrated only on this if time permits. Aconitum napellus rarely indicated in fevers which bring out eruptions. So whatever the eruptive fevers from measles, from chickenpox, whatever the eruptive fevers, rarely indicated in fevers, it may be the suddenness of aconite. If there is a suddenness of aconite, if there is an exposure of the dry northwest wind, if there the anxiety and the life is rendered miserable by fear, it may be seen in the latter part, in the subacute or chronic stage. But in the acute stage, the suddenness, the exposure, all these things, if indicated, then you can think of aconite in any eruptive fever. Otherwise, if there is nothing, there is exposure, or not a symptom of the suddenness, and you are prescribing aconite on the basis of that, this is your first choice of remedy, it is totally rarely indicated in eruptive fever. So it is contraindicated if it is not indicated. And aconite, you know, the acute of sulfur, and both precedes and follows in acute inflammatory condition. In this stage, I should say one thing, it is not written in the relationship, but these two, whichever you are observing in the slides, these are in the relationship part. But one line in the aconite, the wonderful line, that can only the one line can be the keynote symptom of aconitum napellus, that is the congestive stage of inflammation before localization takes place. The wonderful line. I apprehend that even when I was student, I have no understanding of the pathology, I have no deeper understanding of the practice of medicine or any surgery, gynae ops, etc. So what does it mean? That is the congestive active stage of inflammation before localization takes place, and aconite is the first year drug. So, but what is wonderful line is it is that you can feel that something is coming, that something will happen. It is not from psychological point of view that something evil will be happening, but you can observe, you can feel the pain. It may be subjective type. It's still that it is not objective type. So subjective type, you can feel that something will be happening to my hand, and something furuncle or something boil or some inflammatory condition may be happening within 1 or 2 days. That can be observed as observative symptoms after 1 or 2 days. But when these observative symptoms is not there, only subjective symptoms remain, and the active stage of inflammation before localization takes place, this is the usual time of prescribing aconite. And we often miss this stage of giving aconite, and the patient come with us when already localization takes place, the inflammatory products are there. So that was the not stage of aconite. So before that localization takes place in any pathology, it is from boil to pleural effusion. It is from simple furuncle to pericardial effusion. It may be very many, very severe conditions, but whenever it is in very embryological stages, even before embryological stages, whether before localization takes place, the aconite is the sphere of action of aconite, like that. Now next drug, Aesculus hypocastrinum. We know Aesculus hypocastrinum is a very wonderful drug, but I have seen it is very abused by the homeopathic physician for the treatment of piles. But written in relationship, after Collinsonia, when Kalinsonia had improved, whilst you know Kalinsonia with the symptom of heart, with the piles, Aeschylus often cures. So if to complete the work of Kalinsonia, when Kalinsonia worked, and you know the Kalinsonia is the part related with heart. So after Kalinsonia, Aeschylus often cures. And useful after Nox and Sulphur, I intentionally put these slides here, has improved but failed to cure piles. So if you go through very, very small books like Clark Prescriber, even I have seen one or two stalwarts, they even say that in the morning, Sulphur, in the evening, Nox, which is contradictory to homeopathic philosophy. We know the single remedy, but often our Metra Medica people, the Metra Medica stalwarts, even in, it is written in the Clark Prescriber, that is the Sulphur in the morning and Nox in the evening may be a very good treatment protocol approach to patient of hemorrhoids or piles. But it is what written Aeschylus Hippocastinum, useful after Nox Vomica and Sulphur has improved, but not totally cured. It is the stage of Aeschylus Hippocastinum when Nox Vomica and Sulphur may show the improvement, but ultimately fail to cure the hemorrhoids or piles. You can think of Aeschylus Hippocastinum, and whenever you will be thinking of Aeschylus Hippocastinum, don't forget the typical backache of Aeschylus Hippocastinum, because backache is the most accompanying symptom of the of these Aeschylus Hippocastinum with the, all the symptoms, and obviously with the piles or hemorrhoids. Allium sepa, the same part. I am all these slides are from relationship part. In the last part, the relationship part, before aggravation and amelioration part, the bad effects from getting wet. You ask anyone, bad effects from getting wet. Anyone will give you reply of Rastax. Any other one may give you of Dulcamara. And the chronic effect, bad effect, the damp weather, that is of Natrum Salt. But bad effects from getting wet, it is also in Allium Sepa. And whenever you are talking about Allium Sepa, the Allium Sepa, we know about the something of Coryza, like our raw onion, and Allium Sepa is also, I will show you the latter slide, it is very important drug for neuritis. Very many neuritis symptoms, and with the friction symptoms, with the these Allium Sepa is very much effective drug. But bad effects from getting wet, within bracket Rastax, it is only written in the relationship part of Allium Sepa. Same thing, allosuperfida. Allosuperfida very much used in case of amoebic dysentery. I should not say it's bacillary dysentery. You know the basic difference of amoebic dysentery. That is the Entamoeba histolytica, that is the amoebiasis, and it may be in the very active form when trophozoites are there. It may be in the chronic form, then cyst. You can go through the routine examination of stool. If you get the cyst, then it is the chronic amoebiasis caused by the Entamoeba histolytica. And whenever it is related to another dysentery, that is bacillary dysentery, that is the Sigilla group, that is the Sigilla soni, Sigilla boidi, Sigilla flexneri, Sigilla sigilli, all these are of bacillary dysentery with the redness, with the blood, and 20, 30, 40 types of stools, even 40 stools within our 40 times stool within our, these are all the characteristics of bacillary dysentery. Any, not a single symptoms of bacillary dysentery, usually not seen in allosuperfida. So we may think from clinical medicine point of view, that allosuperfida can produce the symptoms, preliminary all the symptoms of the amoebiasis, which is caused by Entamoeba histolytica. So in allosuperfida, very average students even aware about the Nox Vomica and allosuperfida for the amoebiasis. But like it is allosuperfida also very good drug for diarrhea, never confused with the diarrhea and dysentery. So allosuperfida can be useful in diarrhea. Allosuperfida can be used in dysentery also, like Nox Vomica. But what is written in relationship part, like sulfur, in many chronic diseases with abdominal plethora and congestion of portal circulation. So the sphere of action, which should be written in the first part, in the first para, whatever related to your constitution, your sphere of action. But in case of allosuperfida, it is written in the last part, in the relationship part, whatever the sphere of action with the congestion of portal circulation. So, and this is a very important clue for the allosuperfida. So, whenever it relates to piles or hemorrhoids, so obviously there will be something related with our portal circulation, but it is not common to all. It is common to sulfur, it is common to Nox. We know the venous system are very much sphere of action in venous system, in sulfur, in Nox, and also allosuperfida. and it develops surface reaction. In the main text, you can get it, the line, each appears every winter within brackets or INM. So it is the allosaccharina. So develops suppressed reduction like sulfur. So you can see in the relationship part, sulfur is maybe the chronic of allosaccharina. Sulfur, allosaccharina may be the acute, or sulfur may be the chronic in case of. So develops suppressed reduction. It is also found in allosaccharina. Now alumina. Alumina is very, it is in the relationship part. That is one of the chief antidotes for lead poisoning. The Pentad's colleague, elements from lead. Why it is here? Because whenever we tell about something lead, obviously we know about the plumbum metallicum. We know the colleague of the plumbum metallicum. And very often the use of plumbum metallicum is very common to all lead, even the leadampal in one or two instances or to the very good students. But very few students will tell you about the alumina, that it is the chief antidote for lead poisoning. So we should know the lead, because today's scenario, these lead poisoning may not be hampering you because the printers, the printing section of the related to printing machine lead, this is now very old fashioned. You cannot get the most of these one. But the same lead can be, it's found in the water. It's found in the lipsticks of the women. So all the very high priced lipsticks, they're having very high type of lead. And you know the high lead, it's a very often cause of attention deficit hyperactive disorders. All the hyperactive disorders, hyperactive child or girl child, they are instructed not to use the very high priced lipsticks, because all the high priced lipsticks in case of women, female, they have the very high content of lead, which the high lead can cause these type of ADHD and autism spectrum disorders. Not, I should say, autism spectrum disorders is most related to the hyperactivity. So these lead poisoning, thinking of alumina, so we can think from pathological point of view, there may be a one new innovative thinkings of ideas of making your thesis or dissertation of that, the thinking of these antidote chapter of part of the alumina, of the lead poisoning. So we can think of the treatment of alumina to those types of hyperactive child or ADHD child. Amylenum nitrosam. Amyl nitrosam is a very common drug. It is what written, I was talking about the tips, acts prominently by inhalation. So nowadays, you know, inhaler is very common topic, but when I was student more than 25, 30 years back, that time, this inhaler was not very common. At that time, even it is 100 years back, more than 100 years back, it is written that acts promptly by inhalation. And what is important here, we often, we ignore this part, that the third point is curative in the stronger, higher potencies. So even if we go through the syncope patient or the cardiac syncope-like, or whenever the syncope related to multi-position, so we can think of amyl nitrosam for curative purpose whenever it is in the stronger, higher potencies, not in the lower potencies, because lower potencies will act as curative. All these tips written in the relationship part. Another one, anacardium. Anacardium. Whenever we think of symptoms going from right to left, we know a lycopodium and left to right of our lachesis. But also in anacardium, it is written in that part, relationship part, the symptoms are prone to go from right to left. Antimtrach. It's a nowadays, the pandemic COVID-19 is going on. We are very often just observing and hearing the news of the pneumonias, different types of pneumonias, the shock stage of pneumonia, and the typical patient, it is maybe asymptomatic, it may be symptomatic. In case of symptomatic patient in USA states and Spain, France, etc., they are much more asymptomatic patient with a death rate too high. And in all those cases, pneumonitis of the lung is very often an antimtrach. Antimtrach, when lung seems to fail, patient becomes sleepy, as because respiratory failure is going on, or respiratory failure is already started. So it is obvious patients become sleepy. And cough declines or ceases, it supplements Ipecac. So wherever it is written, it's supplementary Ipecac. So Ipecac is the first choice of remedy, then antimtrach, obviously. And it is very common in practice for the children by the homeopaths. But also, it is very often, we know the bad effects of vaccination of Thuja, the silicea, this antimtrach. But what is written here, that when Thuja fails, for the bad effects. And Silicea is not indicated. And Meizerium is not mentioned here. Meizerium is also another one very good drug for the bad effects of vaccination. So in the bad effects of vaccination, if Pujafels and Silicea is not indicated, then you can think of Antimtrak. This is written here. When we often misuse this drug, but we think of this Antimtrak, Silicea, Thuja, these are the drugs. But when and what to apply, this is written here. And before Silicea and Dyspnea, you know the Dyspnea, the shortness of breath, SOB, from foreign bodies in the larynx or trachea. Very wonderful tips. Even it is written in one case that it was already advised for tracheostomy. And before Silicea, the Dyspnea is there and foreign bodies were there. And ultimately, Antimtrak cured that patient. It is in one journal of American at that time of H.C. Allen's book. And he acknowledged this part of H.C. Allen's keynote that before Silicea and Dyspnea from foreign bodies, because whenever it comes to foreign bodies, the Silicea is very common to all the peoples. Everyone knows, even the plus 10 plus, even the very workers, they know about the Silicea with the foreign bodies. But in the very serious condition, when there is shortness of breath, Dyspnea, the patient, the acute trouble of shortness of breath, even before Silicea, Antimtrak may be very much effective. It is written in Antimtrak. And what is written in the last line of the Antimtrak is also very important to today's COVID scenario. That is the icterus. Icterus means, you know, the jaundice. So the jaundice and with the hepatitis of the right lung. So the pneumonia, icterus with pneumonia, especially of right lung, it's very important one. It is in the last line. I will come later on the importance of the last lines of the Allen's, but whenever I am now talking about Antimtrak, so I can remember the last line of Antimtrak, the last stage of the patient, the last stage of the patient with the icterus, with the pneumonia, and the pneumonia in the very advanced stage, the Antimtrak may be effective. The same thing, the face is like corpse, just like dead body. It is the same stage and cyanosis is too much there. That is the carbophage. And there's a different typical differentiation of carbophage and lachesis. One one top fan from very close and another one top fan from very distance. So anything come too near it, that is a lachesis, cannot endure. So it is from distance, that is from lachesis. And whenever fan is from near, there's a carbophage. But both the carbophage, lachesis, and Antimtrak, all the advanced stages of that, and the just death is coming. Even in the Antimtrak, the death rattle can be heard. It is not only the, what is the beauty in homeopathy? That is the Antimtrak can produce the very rattling cough. What is the rattling cough? That is from clinical medicine, that you know, the dry sound and moist sound. This is the moist sound, and within the moist sound, nowadays it is not called moist sound. It is called crepitation. It is called crackles. So crepitation may be fine crepitation. Crepitation may be coarse crepitation. Within the crepitation, the crackles, there may be fine crackles, there may be coarse crackles. So whenever these fine crackles or coarse crackles, these coarse crackles are very much common to tuberculosis patient. This type of rattling sound, the coarse crepitation, is very common to pulmonary tuberculosis patient. It is also common to normal people who are having the thickened pleura due to repeated attack of tuberculosis or repeated attack of pleurisy. Even the patient having repeated attack of pleuritis and patient healed, totally cured. But once or twice, patient having the symptoms of this pleurisy, and now the pleura become thickened, and that thickened pleura may cause this type of rattling sound without any pathology, without any acute pathology at that time. So the coarse lung sound, the rattling sound, that may be the death trap, that may be the last sound before the respiratory failure, before the vomiting, before the last vomiting of the patient, before death, that can be produced Antimtrak. Also, the same rattling cough, which is very common to wheezing chest of the 6 years old or 5 years old or 2 years, 3 years old baby, child, that is also can be covered by Antimtrak. Antimtrak never say that Antimtrak is effective for bronchial pneumonia, Antimtrak is effective for lower pneumonia, Antimtrak is effective in the last stage of pneumonia. It can produce the symptoms, and it is the human being, it is the homeopath, with his judgment, with his clinical knowledge, he will apply this Antimtrak in different conditions, just seeing the indications of the Antimtrak. Because the typical blue cyanos condition of carophage, want of finding, that is not finding in Antimtrak. This is not the indications of Antimtrak. That is the indications of carophage. So whenever, without even in the last stage, you can find the one or two clues, And if you find the clues, that is indication that patient will be cured. Even in the last stage, patient may return to the normal stage if he or she is giving clue, giving indications of anything. So we should think, we should search for, and it is not that you will ask question, because the patient is not in the position to give you reply. It is your observation from clinical point of view, your observation from homeopathic point of view. So antimtat is very crucial drug. Now, another thing, it is pulsatilla in suppressed gonorrhea, terebinth from damp basements, children, all written in antimtat. Children not easily impressed when antimtat seems indicated in coughs require heparin. So all the students always ask, sir, please teach, sir. I have to start practice. Please teach, sir. Everything is in your book. Everything in most of the Metriomedica books, there are very small, small things, but it is very wonderful. It is wonderful to practice in daily practice. You think of these children not easily impressed when antimtart seems indicated in coughs. At that time, require hypersulfur. So it is a wonderful applicability of hypersulfur and in relation with the antimtart. And when the cough will start in spring and autumn, when damp weather commences, cough of children get worse. So these are the timing when most of the patient will give you symptoms. These are all in antimtart. In Apocen, I will go some first because few very slides are very wonderful. I should share this. The Apocenum canadensis, the Blatta orientalis has cured bad cases of general dropsy. But when? After Apis, Apocenum, and Digitalis failed. That is the another. This is one thing. That is not Apocenum. This is Arsenicum album. This is Apocenum. What is written in Apocynum, the symptoms of Blatta orientalis. The similar type of slide is here with the arsenic one. Also, I will show you. But what is important here, under Apocynum, because Blatta orientalis is not the remedy of HCl and Skinode. You can find it in any other Metriomedica books like Borix, etc. And this Blatta orientalis has cured bad cases of general dropsy. When nowadays, dropsy is very old terminology. You know the dropsy. So there is accumulation of fluid. It may be due to nephrotic syndrome. It may be due to very many symptoms, very many clinical medicine disease. When this is, it may be due to cirrhosis. It may be due to hepatic failure. Very many causes. Even from acute septic condition, it may occur. So general dropsy, when Apis fell, when Apocynum canadensis fell, when Digitalis fell, even from cardiac origin. So in that case, Blatta orientalis may be effective, and it is written in Apocynum relation part. Argentum nitricum, wonderful tips. The 200 or 1 mL potency in watery solution as a topical first HCl mentioned about the external application, the topical application in ophthalmia neonatorum of 200 potency, not the mother tincture. 200 or 1 mL potency in watery solution for child. Arnica is very well-known drug for all the mechanical injuries, etc., many years ago. Everyone knows that. But in ailments from spiritual liquors, from charcoal vapors, arnica is often indicated. Aripiprazole should not be given low or repeated often, as bad effects often follow. The higher potency is most prompt and effective. Baritacarb, wonderful. That after baritacarb, sorinum will often eradicate the constitutional tendency to quinzy. Very, very important one, that is the quinzy. And sorinum is very much indicated in quinzy. But what is written here, after baritacarb and sorinum will often eradicate the constitutional tendency to quinzy. So baritacarb may at that time cure the quinzy. Sorinum will also do that. But the baritacarb will eradicate the tendency of quinzy. Bovista, when Rustax seems but fails to cure in chronic urticaria, it is also very important one. What is important, that is in chronic urticaria. And when Rustax seems indicated but fails to cure, you know about the chronic urticaria, it is a very hypersensitive reaction, and in chronic urticaria, it is very much applied in clinical medicine, that is Natramur. The Natramur from the intrinsic cause. That's why Natramur, the violent urticaria after exercise, not after taking any foods. So Bovista when it is related to skin, it is related to dermatology, when Rastrax seems indicated but fails to cure in chronic. So after Rastrax, Bavista is very much effective. Calcreta must not be used before nitric acid and sulfur. Unnecessary complication in children, it may be often repeated. In aged people, should not be repeated. It's a very wonderful suggestion, and I have applied it in my thorough practice of 25 years. I have seen it, that whenever there is too much repetition in aged, calcreta will do harm. But in children, it may be often repeated. So it is, you just follow it to practice. Canthera is the first external and internal, both application of canthera is, and when the vesicle will not appear, it is first written in the relationship part of the canthera. Carbophage, want of susceptibility to well-selected remedies. It is very common to psoriasis. It is very common to sulfur. But it is very common to China. But here you are getting the three drug, want of susceptibility to well-selected remedies, the carbophage, the opium, the valeriana, within the bracket opium and valeriana, the want of susceptibility to well-selected remedies. So these are the clues. Causticum antidotes also paralysis from lead poisoning, and it affects the right side. Causticum is the right-sided drug. It is not written in the text of the causticum. It is written in the relationship part of causticum. Chamomilla, mental calmness contraindicates chamomilla, well known to all of us, but it is written in the relationship part. And in cases spoiled by the use of opium or morphine, in complaints of children, by use of morphine or opium, chamomilla is wonderful sedative in the neuralgic pain. We have seen the toothache, the typical toothache of the wisdom teeth, the tremendous pain of wisdom teeth. I have seen very many cases in my personal life, also in very many stalwarts, that chamomilla in very high potency, like hypericum in high potency or above 200 or 1 m, like chamomilla in very high potency 10 m, it is very, very effective in the case of this type of wisdom tooth. And I have never seen the failure in case of application of chamomilla. If the oral hygiene not go too bad, if the oral hygiene is too bad, then it may happen. But if the oral hygiene is more or less okay, but the tremendous pain due to wisdom tooth, as a painkiller, chamomilla is very, oftenly it is indicated. It may be chamomilla, it may be hypericum, it may be another drug. But in most of the cases, if you are not getting the indication in case, then you can try the chamomilla with a higher potency. Cena. Cena is very abused drug. Whenever anyone is thinking of any worm affection, so Cena is used, Cena santonine. But what is wonderful thinking, that is in pertussis. You know the pertussis and the whooping cough. After Drosera has relieved the severe symptoms, even it can complement the work of Drosera. Drosera means the whooping cough. And Drosera is one of the most important tubercular drug, which can be effective in whooping cough, which can be effective in adult phthisis, which can be effective nowadays. It has been used in attention deficit hyperactive disorders because this hyperactivity may be related to tubercular diathesis. So this Cena has the tremendous capability of complement Drosera. This is a very wonderful thing. Even is it can cure aphonia, to loss of voice from exposure when aconite, phosphorus, spongia failed. You know the aconite? You know the spongia of aphonia? Even when all these drugs fail, the Cena may cure it. It frequently may be thought of in children as an epidemic remedy when adults require other drugs. In case of children, if any type of epidemic occurs related to child disease or related to the Cena, maybe in most of the cases, it has the capability of being one of the genus epidemicus in case of child. Santonine sometimes cures in worm affections when Cena seems indicated but fails. This is the real area of santonine. It is not that I give santonine and I get all the results. Oh, I am not favorable of Cena. It is not like that. Whenever Cena fails, if there is indication but Cena fails, you can try, you can think of santonine because it is picked up from Herring's Guiding Symptoms, and Herring's Guiding Symptoms is a wonderful book with the clinical practice. Even you can see in the Herring's Guiding Symptoms, there are one sign that is called theta, which is the clinically verified symptoms. It's a very wonderfully, because himself, Herring's, all the disciples, they have verified this. Even all those verified symptoms also picked up by H.C. Allen's. And it is a wonderful book for the first exposure of the first year, second year. And also it is a very wonderful book for the senior one or even the very senior professionals, homeopathic professionals, because at that time they can realize the real meaning of these Allen skin. Cinchona is useful in the bad effects from excessive pre-drinking. Whenever the bad effects of excessive pre-drinking, we think of thuja, we think of pulsatilla, and we think of another one drug that is called thia. Thia, it is also very wonderful drug in Bori. There is all the tea, excessive tea drinking bad effects. But cinchona has also the capability of that, the excessive tea drinking, as it is right, it is written in the relationship part. Cocculus, whenever it is a matter of umbilical hernia, we think of Nux vomica. But cocculus has cured umbilical hernia with obstreperous constipation when Nux vomica failed. No one told us. But it is written in the relationship part that when Nux vomica failed, with but one thing, another point, there is the obstinate constipation. Obstipation is there, and umbilical hernia is not cured by Nux vomica. Cocculus indica, which is very often used for the car sickness, cocculus, the vomiting, the typical vomiting, but cocculus can cure umbilical hernia. Collinsonia has cured colic. Colic, it is collinsonia, not colisonthesis, not colosynthesis. It has cured colic after colophyllum, colocynth and Nux vomica failed. So whenever it relates to colic, it's less to pain abdomen. It may be forward bending like colocynthis. It may be Nux vomica like ineffectual arching. It may be bad back bending like diascoria. But whenever this colocynthis and Nux vomica fail, the collinsonia can cure the colic. This is also written in the our relationship part. The corneum maculatum, very often used for the bacillar, old bacillar, for the any heart swelling from injury, or for the vertigos, for the left-sided affections, for the prostatic benign enlargement of prostate. Even it is a very wonderful drug of malignancy, the malignant tumor. Patients requiring corneum often improve from wine or stimulus. Though persons susceptible to corneum cannot take alcoholic stimulants when in health. So being a corneum patient, he is not fond of any liquor or any type of stimulants or wine. But the patients requiring corneum often improve from wine. And what is wonderful, how the depth of this corneum maculatum, how this corneum can be effective in any malignant conditions, in any cancerous conditions. That is followed well by sorainam. We know the sorainam. Sorainam has the capability to cure or to palliate the cancerous patient. So, corneum is followed well by sorainam in tumors of mammy, in tumors, breast tumors, with threatening malignancy. Malignancy yet to prove. But threatening malignancy, from the observatory symptoms, from the subjective symptoms, you are thinking of this mammy tumor may go to malignancy. And if you are getting all the characteristics of corneum maculatum, you can think of corneum. But without indications, you never think of any this type of drug in very serious conditions. It is very often that in incurable diseases like cancer, you cannot get all the clues. In very many cases, the pathological prescriptions are there. But always, you can get few characteristics. On the basis of few characteristics, you use it as palliative. But that type of palliative treatment is very often useful than the palliative treatment on the blind faith or on the organopathic type of treatment. Drosera. Hahnemann says, what is said, it is very often, you will say, we know, it is written that 30 potency is the only potency Drosera. Definite. We often use these Drosera in a single, but what Hahnemann said is very, you go to minutely, never give a second dose immediately after the fast. He never said you give only first dose. He said you can give second dose, but not immediately after the first dose. Don't think that today you are giving the first dose and the next day you will be giving the second dose, or after 6 hours you are giving the second dose. So if it requires, you may give the second dose of Drosera, but never give a second dose immediately after the fast. This is the very wonderful advice given by our master Hahnemann. So the cure takes place, and what type of dearness, Dr. Hahnemann only can say this, that one single dose of the 30th potency is sufficient to cure entirely epidemic whooping cough. And I have seen my cases, even in my personal family life, I have seen the wonderful effect of this whooping cough by Drosera, by Mesarium. I have seen by Stikta, how wonderfully only single dose. the cure takes place surely between 7 and 8 days. Now, Dalcamara. Whenever you can ask anyone about the Dalcamara, Dalcamara is a very historic medicine because through the Dalcamara, the in India, homeopathy took entry. And by Raja Ranjit Singh Ji, the Dalcamara is often prescribed by the doctor. And ultimately, Dalcamara in nervous and any symptoms related to nervous system, Dalcamara cured that. But what is written, it is very wonderful in Dalcamara. That is similar to mercury in Thialism, glandular swelling, bronchitis, diarrhea, susceptibility to weather changes, night pains. So all these syphilitic manifestations, all these mercury symptoms, the characteristic symptoms of mercury is written in Dalcamara. And what are the symptoms? The Thialism, the salivation, we know, the glandular swellings, the barometers, mercury with the weather, the bronchitis, the diarrhea, the susceptibility to weather changes. These are all obviously the night pains of the syphilis. So Dalcamara is often similar to mercury. And Calisol is the chemical analog. So for the bad effects of mercury, hypersulfur is well known to us. Carbamazepine and hypersulfur for the bad effects of mercury. But Dalcamara can be also thought of for the bad effects or abuse of mercury. You know the Eupatorium perfulatum is wonderful drug and all the breakbone disease for the dengue type of fever, even not in the hemorrhagic dengue type of fever, but in general dengue, it is very much effective. I am not telling that it is specific in dengue, but in most of the cases, even our Central Council for Research in Homeopathy, they have very many papers and established papers on Eupatorium perfulatum, even in our West Bengal and Calcutta district. This year also in West Bengal, it is due to pandemic, COVID-19, the situation is not now to serve, but the government of West Bengal already decided to propagate this Eupatorium perfulatum to all the districts, to all the primary health centers as a preventive one. So Eupatorium perfulatum already established its sphere of action related to the symptomatology of the dengue is very much similar to that. Apart from the hemorrhagic manifestations, which is the another drug, there is a Crotala sorbitus is one of the another very good, wonderful drug which acted very well in Delhi area when hemorrhagic dengue was there. So Bryonia is the nearest analog, having but how wonderful comparison, having free sweat but pains keep patient quiet. It is the Bryonia. And Eupatorium has scanty sweat and pains make patient restless. So Bryonia is totally quiet, Eupatorium is totally restless. Bryonia free sweat, Eupatorium scanty sweat. So that's similar, simple differentiation within the Eupatorium perfulatum relationship part. Ferummet should never be given in syphilis, always aggravates the condition. It is also of that part. So whenever you are thinking syphilis is in the background, never give ferummet. Hypersulfur antidotes the bad effects of mercury. I already told this. But what is important, the last part, the psoriatic skin affections of sulfur are dry, itching, abrasion by scratching and not sensitive to touch. While hyper, the skin is unhealthy, suppurating, moist and extremely sensitive to touch. This is a very wonderful differentiation of sulfur and hypersulfur. Iodinum should not be given during lying in period except in hypotensy. Calicarb will bring on the menstruation when Natramute, though apparently indicated, fails. It is said by Hahnemann that Calicarb, if Natramute is prescribed on the indications and it fails, then give Calicarb. And one of our very Maitreya Medica guru, that is of Calcutta Homeopathic Medical College, ex-professor HOD of Maitreya Medica, I am fortunate enough to see few lessons from him also, Dr. S.K. Dubey, our Guruji. So, and I also told that when Calicarb fails, then he said it is the tuberculin. Even I can remember Dr. Dubey told me that the tuberculinum is the remedy whenever after pregnancy, even it is 7 months, 8 months, 9 months, there is amenorrhea after since pregnancy, or even after 1 year, the tuberculinum may be the drug. So you can think of Natramure, you can think of whenever it fails of Calicarb, and whenever the Calicarb fails of tuberculinum. Creosote. Often carbamazepine and creosote are inimical, and creosote, you know, the older looks than he is. And what is important here, creosote has got its sphere of action in the malignant conditions. And creosote is followed well by arsenic, phosphorus, sulfur in cancer and disease of a malignant tendency. So not only of creosote, also creosote establishes the condition of arsenic, the phosphorus and the sulfur. these three drugs can be used in malignant conditions and in cancerous conditions. Lacadenum, wonderfully, because I lachesis and lacadenum I have seen in very many old journals of West Bengal, very Hanumanian gleanings. Most of the stalwarts, they use lacadenum and lachesis specifically in 30 potency and single dose. It is written in Allen that it generally acts best in single dose lacadenum, and it is the wonderful remedy for related to your throat. Wonderful remedy. Probably no remedy in the Metramedica presents a more valuable pathogenesis in symptoms of the throat, or one of that will better repay careful study. Lacopodium, deep-seated long-acting remedy, should rarely be repeated after improvement begins. This you should know. This is the second part. Lacopodium never give very infrequent repetition is the characteristic of lacopodium. And also it is advisable not to begin the treatment with the lacopodium, first of all. If it is clear-cut lycopodium, all the characteristic symptoms are very much open. You can see the lycopodium in your patient, you give lycopodium. It is applicable to all. Whenever you are getting very good indications, you don't give attention to any advice. You give that much. But if you are not getting the indications like that of lycopodium, don't start your treatment with first drug as lycopodium. Sometimes acts best when given in hot weather. This is the why MacFos is specifically in biochemic. It is given in hot lukewarm water. It is written in Allen's relationship part. Magnesium Fos acts best when given in hot weather. Medrinum, the burning feet of sulfur, restless fidgety legs, and feet of ginkum, both are seen in medrinum. Mercury, but important, the time, if time permits, I should say. That the in mercury, what important is here, that is the should not be given before or after sulfur, it is not very important. The third point I should say that mercury, if you think that you have to antidote mercury, then by a stronger potency or high potency of mercury, if the symptoms correspond, you can give. If you are thinking after giving mercury, the patient is retroating, or the syphilis, the anti-syphilitic part of mercury is causing harm to the patient, then you can antidote the same. If you get the indications of mercury, then you can, the same remedy, you can give it high potency that can antidote. It is wonderfully, and I have in more than 4 or 5 cases, I have seen it. It is wonderfully, it wonderful act. Natramute should never be given during fever paroxysm, like intermittent fever, organon. You know the intermittent fever. It is during the when the it is the peak is going on. We should not prescribe the medicine, and cannot often be repeated in chronic cases without an intercurrent called for by the symptoms. If vertigo and headache be very persistent, you know natramute means headache. So prostration be prolonged after natramute, Nag Zomica will relieve. So we should think the relationship of natramur with the Nag Zomica. Even in case of headache, when natramur fails, the Nag Zomica may give relief. Natram sulfur must change position frequently, but it is painful and gives little relief. It is within bracket causticum. You can get this symptom in the main text of causticum. So whenever there is nothing to change the position, but out of agony, it may be out of agony. It may be due to hyperactivity. It may be due to physical pain, anything. But not getting relief, but he has to change the position. This is the indication of giving natrum salt as well as causticum. Nitric acid, often difficult to distinguish from mercury, but it is at a black-haired people is nitric acid and light-haired people to mercury. But what is important that nitric acid ailments resulting from abuse of mercury, it is also from ailments from abuse of mercury, but especially if there be erythism and bad effects of repeated doses of digitalis. Nag Zomica in evening part. Petroleum, what important part, the skin symptoms are worse in winter, better in summer, like alumina. If suppressed, causes diarrhea. So skin symptom suppression causes diarrhea. It is not only in sulfur, it is also in petroleum. Phosphorus, Hanuman says, acts most beneficial when patients suffer from chronic loose stool or diarrhea. Chronic loose stool or diarrhea, maybe due to chronic diarrhea, maybe due to amebiasis, maybe due to amoebic typhlitis, maybe due to malabsorption syndrome, maybe due to intestinal tuberculosis or the doughy feeling of abdomen, maybe due to AIDS, acute immunodeficiency syndrome, chronic diarrhea. So there are very many diseases in which chronic diarrhea, it may be due to anxiety neurosis. It may be due to right now for COVID-19 patient with the argentum nitricum type constitution, with the carbonitrogenate constitution, very anticipatory constitution, and the chronic loose diarrhea is happening due to anxiety neurosis. So the phosphorus also has got some type of carbonitrogenate constitution type with the tubercular type. So phosphorus has the capability of producing this symptom, but it is beneficial when it is chronic. So if you get the three-legged stools, you can give phosphorus. Sorainam, it is very often after arnica in traumatic affections of ovaries. Arnica is very well known for trauma. And even the traumatic affections of ovaries, in case of any trauma, arnica may be thought of. But after arnica, sorainam is the remedy to cure it. This is written in the relationship part. And sulfur follows sorainam well in mammary cancer. So after sorainam, sulfur follows well in mammary cancer. So never forget sulfur in cancer treatment. Pulsatilla, one of the best remedies with which to begin the treatment of a chronic case. So lycopodium, not to start with lycopodium, otherwise indicated, strongly indicated. And pulsatilla, it is advised to begin the treatment with the chronic case. And like, there are two other remedies, that is the calcarea curb and sulfur. So you can initiate the treatment. And patients anemic, chlorotic, who have taken much iron, quinine and tonics even years before, this is written. And nowadays, you can find in most of the patients with this, with the anemia and taking all the iron, quinine, tonics, etc., etc. So pulsatilla is the drug. I can remember the last line of the pulsatilla, that is the nervousness intensely felt about the ankles. And if you think this type of tubercular patient, they're very weak from the ankle weakness. You can see it in carboanemones. You can see it in pulsatilla. You can see it in very many drugs with the weak ankles, with the intensely felt about the ankles, with the nervousness, with the carbonitrogenate constitution, with the background tubercular diathesis. All these accumulate your pulsatilla patient with the sinus, with the suppressive nature. Pyrogen, latent pyrogenic process, patient continually relapsing after apparent simulimum. Rustux, CPI is often quickly ameliorated by itching and burning of rustux, the vesicles drying up in a few days. So CPR can cure the itching and burning of rustux, the vesicles, very quick. The dermatitis should never be treated. This is the line. It is very wonderfully cautioned. The dermatitis should never be treated by tropical methodical applications. They only suppress, never cure. It is written under rustux. Sambucus relieves ailments from abuse of arsenic. Nowadays, all is taking arsenic amalgam 30. The CCRH advisory is to take one drop once a day, 3 days, or in the red hot zone areas, there may be for 15 days interval, but from all the shops, they are taking two drops, three drops of arsenic amalgam. So relieves ailments from abuse of arsenic. Sambucus is the drug, Sambucus. Sanguinaria canadensis has a dynamic remedy for the narcosis of opium. Sarsaparilla, frequently called for after abuse of mercury. So after abuse of mercury, you get dalcamara, you get phytolacta, you get hypersulfur. Now you get the sarsaparilla, the abuse of mercury. Selenium, it's checked by mercurials or sulfur, often required sulfur. Even you can think the depth of selenium, even the itching of sulfur, the sulfur is thought of the best drug, sulfur 6 by WADV therapeutics. Sulfur 6 is the best drug for scabies or most often indicated in scabies. And 6 is the very good potency as per WADV and few other stalwarts. So in low potency or 36 or 30 potency. Even the mercury also, the itch aggravate from the heat of the bed. So mercury and sulfur thought of the best drug for the scabies type of or itching eruptions. But what is written in selenium, that each checked by mercury or sulfur, you often require selenium. It is not that the sulfur or mercury can end the treatment. To complete the treatment, the selenium may be required. CPR single dose often act curatively for many weeks. Stramonium after overaction from repeated doses of belladonna in whooping cough. Sulfur calcarea must not be used before or sulfur. Sulfuric acid. It is one part with three parts of alcohol, 10 to 15 drops, three times daily for 3 or 4 weeks has been successfully used to subdue the craving for liquor, for craving for alcohol. It can. It is as per claim by Herring, and that is picked up by H.C. Allen in the relationship part. The, in the Tabacan, you can get all the antidotes for abuse of tobacco, all the antidotes for ipecac, excessive nausea, arsenic, bad effect, nugs, vomica, phosphorus, ignatia, clematis, CPR, lycopodium, all related to different differentiating factor. Lycopodium, impotence, spasm, CPR, neuralgic affections of right side of face. So all these cases, even the Tabacum, the constant chewing of tobacco, khoini, like that, in 200 or 1 in potency. So all the antidotes, abuse of tobacco, you can find in the relationship part of Tabacum. Tarantula, very often drug used nowadays for attention deficit hyperactive disorders, ADHD hyperactive child. And you can think that all the special educators, they advise all those hyperactive child to get the friction of the nerve ends. What is written in tarantula, termini of nerves become so irritated and sensitive that some kind of friction was necessary to obtain relief. So whenever you are getting this type of hyperactive child who get relief from this, from like this, so you can think of your tarantula. Terebinthine recommends as a prophylactic in malarial and African fevers, because terebinthine in all those malarial and African fevers, the kidney affections, the renal affections is much more. Terebinthine is a very good drug for any type of nephritis and nephrotic type of syndrome. Tuberculinum bacillinum, as per Allen, when sorinum sulfur or the best selected remedy fails to relieve or permanently improve, follows sorinum as a constitutional remedy in hay fever and asthma. So as a constitutional remedy. And what is important? Hydrastis to fatten patients cured with tuberculinum. So you have patients cured with tuberculosis. If the patients after tuberculosis to fat, to make the patients fatty, you can use hydrastis. Veratrum often remains bad effects of excessive use of alcohol and tobacco. Now the text of each remedy, it is not, the time will not permit to go through the X remedy text. The first line or paragraph in the most remedy covers the whole field of the action, like aconite, generally indicated in acute or recent cases occurring in young persons, especially girl of a full plethoric habit who led a sedentary life, persons easily affected by. So everything you can get, that is the suddenness, that is the atmospheric change, that is the only for the congestive stage of inflammation, and just after that, the mental conditions of the aconite. So like second, third, or fourth line, next 3 or 4 paragraph refer to the causes, ailments from, and refers to the different characteristics of the guiding features of the remedy. Like all, even Hahnemann said, whenever aconite is chosen homeopathically, you must above all observe the moral symptom, whatever the suddenness may be there, whatever the exposure may be there. But if the typical fear, the not the fear, I can say it, the anxiety, the agony, if that is not there, you cannot think of aconite. So whenever you are thinking of aconite, then only you should consider the moral symptom. Without the moral symptom, you cannot think of aconite. And the, all the other rest, the different pathological clinical symptoms, the peculiar uncommon symptoms, morbidity, you can see the Ethuja synapium in the second or third line. Whenever you ask anyone about Ethuja synapium, he will say something related to your child symptom and something related to your epilepsy. But Ethuja synapium is very good drug for cerebral palsy. I am not talking that by giving Ethuja synapium, cerebral palsy will be cured. But the type of cerebral palsy patient often requires Ethuja synapium. And if you go to the symptoms, that's idiocy in children, incapacity to think, confused. These are the symptoms, mind symptoms of the cerebral palsy patients. So incapacity to children. Even in the physical symptoms, children cannot stand, unable to hold up the head. It is unable to hold up the head. It is a different part. It is with abrotenum. It can be seen in protein energy malnutrition. It can be seen in marasmus. It can be seen in kwashiorkor. But whenever children cannot stand, idiocy in children, incapacity to think, confused, these are the all symptoms of cerebral palsy. So you don't think that the cerebral palsy child, I am not only talking of curative part of the cerebral palsy, but the cerebral palsy child may be sick, may require remedy, may require, it is not the surgery possible. So whenever you can, the cerebral palsy child, and he is something pain in the stomach, something pain in the other side, or anything component related to physical ailments, you can think of Ethuja synapium. Even by giving as a constitutional remedy of the Ethuja synapium, if the symptom corresponds, you can see the, you can observe the improvement in the patient's reaction. I am not telling that because the pathological condition is so grave, it is most of the cases in cerebral palsy, it is beyond the reversible stage, it is irreversible stage. May I get a few 5 or 10 minutes to coordinator? I'm asking what the time, or the time is over. Hello. 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 So I was talking about Arnica Montana. I was talking about Arnica Montana second line.
Sir, you bad effects.
Hello?
Yes, sir, you can continue.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So the Arnica Montana, for the bad effects resulting from mechanical injuries, it is all things I was talking about. The second line, third line, specially adapted to those who remain long impaired by the side mechanical injuries. After this, the characteristic symptoms of arthritis. It is giving example that these are the second, third, fourth line, like that, examples of Naxumica, first line. You can think the all the keen, irritable, careful, zealous, persists the constitution of the patient. The second line, debauches of a thin, irritable, nervous disposition, prone to indigestion and hemorrhoids. These are all the second, third line, ultimately last line relations. Acteorismosa. But very important line, even we misuse this, is the heart troubles from reflex symptoms of uterus or ovaries. You know acteorismosa, the semicircular, the heart troubles from reflex symptom of uterus or ovaries. The same thing in case of any spasm, hysterical or epileptic reflex from uterine disease. So we can think of any disease, any complaint. If the disease may be rheumatoid arthritis, the disease may be arthritic symptoms, but if it is from reflex from uterine disease, we can think of semicircular. I have an experience, and I have seen also to very many senior stalwarts with all those. We have gathered all the experiences, and in my personal life also, in personal practice, I have seen the efficacy of semicircular in the patients of rheumatoid arthritis or the seropositive or seronegative RA, and whenever the patient having history of hysterectomy. After hysterectomy, the arthritis developed. The arthritis developed from the reflex of uterine origin, from the thinking of this relation of these symptoms from the Allen's, as the spasms or the heart troubles, reflex of uterine symptoms. We have experimentally used these symptoms with the semicircular in case of arthritis, reflex from hysterectomy, and we got good result. We get good results. Scholarship already I told it, but what important part, there is a follicular pharyngitis. It is a wonderful drug of scholarship. So not only use scholarship in only piles or hemorrhoids or with the backache, but think of scholarship also in the follicular pharyngitis with the violent burning, with the pharyngitis inclination to swallow, and with burning, pricking, stinging, and dry constricted process. So, Isoflex is also very good drug for follicular pharyngitis. an allium sepa. I was telling that with the neuritis, the what important thing, there is a sore and raw spots on feet, especially healed from friction, and traumatic chronic neuritis, neuralgia of stump after amputation. So after operation, post-operative surgery, neuralgia of stump after amputation, burning, stinging, allium sepa, wonderful drug. It is in the text. It is in the text of now the different type of constitution, like lymphatic constitution, agnus gastrus. For lymphatic temperament, that is Baptisia. There are very many constitution found in H.C. Allen's keynotes, that is the choleric, phlegmatic, sanguine, melancholic, or nervous. In the choleric, easily becomes angry. Intellectual persons, liver and gastric type with bilious, but novelty seeking is a very important thing. With the choleric temperament, novelty seeking is very important one. The phlegmatic, very sluggish, leukophlegmatic, slow, flaccid, predominance of lymph, and synonyms, there is a lymphatic, like you can find it in Calcarea carp. This is a persistent. This is a phlegmatic type, like sluggish, but he or she is very persistent. You can see the phlegmatic constitution of Agnus gastrus, Asterias rubens, Hippersulf. You can see the phlegmatic temperament of Baptisia. There are difference of constitution and temperament. There is the Baptisia thuja, Mesarium pulsatilla. This is the phlegmatic temperament. You can see the sanguine temperament, the preponderance of blood, very redness, flushed, emotional, proud, heart, blood, arteries, and reward dependent. Always reward dependent, or one to be praised, one to be some reward dependent. It is very important in case of sanguinaria. Melancholic, another one, the sadness, depression, thoughtful, introspective. And in case of that, the sphere of action in the nerve, lung, spleen, harm avoidance. Never the melancholic personality, harm avoidance. Now the importance of last line, I was telling about this, the H.C. Allen's last line. Most of the drug, you can find the last line is very important, like allosocotrina. Itching and burning is anus, preventing sleep. It is also found in indigo. So for the pinworms, you know the pinworms, the Enterobius vermicularis, and the pinworm, often this pinworm may be a carcinogenic manifestation. In the carcinosin drug, you can find the pinworms. In the cancerous diathesis, you can find the pinworms. So pinworms is found in indigo. Pinworm is found in allosocotrina. Allosocotrina is related to portal congestion. This pinworm is related to our spigelia also. Spigelia is also for roundworm, also for pinworm, especially pinworm, spigelia. So all these drugs can be used in worm manifestation, but all these drugs can be used in any cancerous conditions also, because the pinworms itself is the cancerous diathesis, the symptoms of the cancerous diathesis. So in allosocotrina, it's the last line, it is the itching and burning is anus, preventing sleep. So it is also one of the drug may be thought of in any cancerous condition, allosocotrina. Camphor, all sequelae of measles, all the sequelae of measles. You know the measles, you know the sequelae of measles, the complications and sequelae, the difference, and the sequelae, like there is one very grave, fatal complication happen in measles. That is the subacute sclerosing panencephalitis, SSPE, the death occur. But we have never tried this camphor with the sequelae of measles, and not such study is done to this, that whether it was effective or not. But in most of the complications, camphor may be effective. Argentum might become last line. Chili, when uncovered, yet feels smothered if wrapped up. So the contradiction symptoms like ignatia, you know the ignatia, you cannot find what is the complaint of the patient. The patient will give you contradictory symptoms. Patient will give you 4 symptoms of duodenal ulcer, 5 symptoms of gastric ulcer, and you will be confused with what the diagnosis will be. So for your convenience, there is one diagnosis terminology, that is the peptic ulcer symptom, but you never find the right symptoms of ignatia. And whenever you will be finding that there is nothing complaint of the patient, then you can think of ignatia. This is also one indications of ignatia. Similar type Argentum nitricum, you can find the contradictory symptoms, and this is the typical type of symptoms of Argentum nitricum, what is found in malarial type of fever, also in the any case of mental related disease conditions. Pulsatilla, last line, I have already told about the nervousness, intensely felt about the ankles, which is very, very much related to the signage of the pulsatilla. The typical characteristics, indecisiveness of the pulsatilla. Typical, there is the nervousness. And whenever he or she is nervous, usually she is nervous, intensely felt about the ankles. It is very often seen. So never try to search or try to ask the patient to know the patient by asking. Definitely you will ask, But your observation is very much important to diagnose the patient. Ruta, backache relieved by lying down. Very wonderful symptom, backache relieved by lying down. So it is from clinical medicine point of view, we can think of that the backache never relieved by lying down itself in case of any ankylosing spondylosis, because ankylosing spondylosis patient will not be very in his or her comfort zone whenever he will be lying on back. So apart from the ankylosing spondylosis, if there is prolapsed intervertebral disc, PID, in that case, whenever he will lie, that it is good. It is the backache relieved by lying down. So there are very many conditions which may give you indications of Ruta, but not only based on only one or last line symptom you can prescribe Ruta. There are two or three another characteristic symptom must be there. The Ammonmuir, offensive sweat of the feet. You can get all the drugs of offensive sweat in the Ammonmuir last line. There is the Alumina, Graphitis, Sorinam, Sanicula, Silicea, and Ammonmuir. These are all offensive sweat. Calibicromicum, sexual desire absent in fleshy people. This is the Calibicromicum. And just before that line, this is the prolapse uteri of Calibicromicum. Whenever there is the sexual desire absent and fleshy people, so fleshy people, it indicates the fleshy people, the sluggishness, the psychotic manifestations. So everything is very loose, very sluggish. And whenever their sexual desire is not there, so the uterus will prolapse. It is obvious it will prolapse. So Calibicromicum is related to like that. I can remember the CPA also. CPA, the leucorrhea is much more there. In CPA, there is prolapse also, like Calibicromicum. But CPA is not fleshy like Calibicromicum. But in CPA also, there is prolapse because CPA is very much aversion to her husband also. She has very limited sex because that CPA becomes after the Natramur. Natramur was the very mental patient with the chronic mental ailments. With the chronic mental ailments, the Natramur patient with the headache, with the migraine type of headache, with the mental tension, with the mental complaints, ultimately, these Natramur patient become CPA, and whenever she becomes CPA, she has aversion to husband, true aversion to sex, and after that, there will be leucorrhea and then the prolapse. So these are the conditions, these are the one after one. That's why Natramur and CPA. Like again, Calica, very much inclined to take cold. It is in the last line in Calica, very much inclined to take cold. Creosote, violent corrosive itching of pudenda. It is the pudenda and vagina. This is a very important part of creosote. There is a itching of pudenda and vagina. Also, we can get in another one or two drug. Ledampal, long remaining discoloration after injuries, black and blue, places become green. These are wonderful indications. It is not only arnica, it is, and I have seen one case, very wonderful case, which was totally advised for the amputation from frostbite, and only on the basis of this line. And the cold application ameliorate, Ledampal cured that case in high potency. In my personal relation, I have seen this case, the wonderful action of Ledampal. Antimtert, ikras with pneumonia, especially of right lung. This all are the last line. Arnica, retention or incontinence of urine after labor, last line. Arsenicum album, complaints written annually. The fluoric acid, the last line itself, it totally keynotes of fluoric acid, rapid caries of teeth, fistula dentalis or lacrimalis, extrastosis of bone, so face. So here you can give the Hecla. Hecla larvae is very often used for extrastosis. It is like marble-like extrastosis of face or bone, but it is also found in fluoric acid. And under fluoric acid, the Hecla larvae is written in the alens. So the typical fluoric acid with the syphilis in the background. Lycopodium, waking at night, feeling hungry. This is the symptom of gastric ulcer. So you can see the differentiating point of duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. The midnight hunger pain is a characteristic one of the peptic ulcer symptom of gastric ulcer. And you can find these disease symptom found in Lycopodium in the last line, in the bracket Sina and Sorinam. Lysine, sensitiveness of vagina, rendering coition painful. So lysine vagina is very much sensitive, so aversion to coition. Again, the same thing you can think of Lilium tigritum. It is so sensitive that she can guard the Lilium tigrium, also very much sensitive. Also muriatic acid, very much sensitive. So these sensitive vagina also found in lysine in the last line. Mercury, the last line of mercury, just the paralysis agitans or the Parkinsonism. If you think the patient having the mercury type of constitution, two or three large type of tongue, the salivation, all that night aggravation, and with the paralysis agitans, with the Parkinsonism, you can think of mercury. This is the last line, trembling extremities, especially hands, paralysis agitans, thuja, nails deformed, brittle. It is a wonderful thing of Helen, that is the nails deformed. This is the one line, and nails brittle is the another line. So it can be found in antiproof, it can be found in thuja, it can be found in very many psychotic drugs, it can be found in graphitis also. But these nails is not deformed, not brittle, but if it is only blackish and with the tinea infection is there, then we should not think of these drugs. We should may think of bacillinum or other type of drugs. The sulfuric acid, weak and exhausted from deep-seated dyspepsia, no other symptoms. Tarantula, sexual excitement extreme, even to mania, spasms of uterus, pruritus, vulva becomes intolerable. I was talking about the sensitive vagina of platina, of tarantula, of these. This is a very important one. Sulfur, movement in abdomen as of a child. It is also found in Proca and Thuja, but this is the last line of sulfur, movement in abdomen as of a child. This is the fixed idea, which is the found in Thuja, but you know the fixed idea is of psychotic origin, also of syphilitic origin, and you can find it in sulfur, which is a great antipsychotic drug. But if you go to the rubrics of the repertory in the psychosis and syphilis, you can find the sulfur. Selenium, emaciation of the affected parts. You don't think it is very simple thing, the emaciation of the affected parts. Emaciation of affected parts, it can be seen. It can be seen in motor neuron disease, in anterior horn cell disease, in any nervous disorders of grave, if maybe cause fatal. So if, even in plumbum metallicum, we can find these symptoms, emaciation of affected part. It is found in graphitis. It is found in petroleum. This emaciation of affected part, it is also found in selenium. So selenium also has got the tremendous capability to produce this type of grave symptoms. Syphilinum, in the last para of the syphilinum, syphilitics of patients who have heart sanka treated by local means as a result of suffered from throat and skin troubles for years are nearly always benefited by this remedy at commencement of treatment, unless some other remedy is clearly indicated. So think of syphilinum. Even I should recommend the Roberts and Stuart Close book for philosophy, obviously of our organon of medicine, but we should recommend this as to know the syphilis, the syphilitic patient. The figures of strepsiaceae in the last line, symphytum, the pain in the eye after a blow, this is in the last line. Even the sanguinaria canadensis can be used in acne for the scanty menstruation, it is in the last line. And the sepia, already I have told. A few more examples from medrinum. Medrinum, you know, the woman with the PID, with the ovarietes, with the salpingitis, the cancers, all things about the medrinum. And in the last part, relations and modality, most important areas, it will help us in differentiation of the remedy and guide us in the selection of the remedy. I should conclude with the last slide, that is at par HCLN. The life work of the student of homeopathic Metra Medica is one of constant comparison and differentiation. So these HCLN keynote characteristics will give you an ample time or ample, I can say, that you can get the opportunity, ample opportunity to go through the constant comparison and differentiation, because all the keynotes are here. You have not to go to the very voluminous books of Herring's and all those things. You can consult it as a reference books. But with all these keynotes characteristics, you can compare all the similar type of drugs with the relationship part and with the help of all the other reference books. And this should be the first one book through the new very beginners to go through. And just to go through, just to read it. And also, I should recommend all the seniors one, just to again and again, whenever they are becoming the senior professionals now with the, all their experiences, they should again go through this HCLN just to realize, just to perceive the beauty of Metra Medica in the light of clinical medicine, practice of medicine. Thank you all. And I should recommend you all to go to HCLN, and it should be kept in your table of a daily practitioners in OPD, IPD, and in your private practice. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I will call upon Principal Dr. S.P. Singh sir to give vote of thanks. And if there is any kind of doubt, so anyone can write in the chat box. Sir, there was one doubt of one homeopath. Yeah. When we should prescribe the no-sodes and what would be the potency of the no-sodes?
The no-sodes, usually no-sodes can be, first of all, from homeopathic philosophy point of view, no-sodes can be prescribed as per indications. But there are very many indications, very many approach of the no-sode prescription. One is very popular, that is as intercurrent. Like you, one can prescribe thuja, one but in between calcleophas and thuja, bacillinum maybe as the intercurrent. Even it is not recommended just to initiate the treatment with the no-sode, but as an intercurrent it can be used. Or if you think the no-sode is the, there are very many indications of the no-sode and clear-cut pictures of the no-sode, then you should go through. You should take it as the first one. But the indications should be there. So if indications is there, you can prescribe no-sode. As an intercurrent remedy, you can go through no-sode. As an organopathic remedy, in palliative cases, you can recommend no-sode. Also, there are very many no-sodes of bowel no-sodes. Bowel no-sodes are very useful, like thuja and psychotic co, like argentum nitricum with the dysentery co compound. These are the no-sodes we can think of. You are prescribing thuja, but not very much improving. You can think of bowel.
Okay, sir. Sir, there was one more doubt that WHO claims that asthma can never be cured by any remedy. It can only be prevented.
Not asthma. I never told this. Bronchial asthma.
No.
Who said that? I told
WHO,
this about
WHO. WHO.
What? No, it is not like that. Even the atopic dermatitis can go to this type of bronchial asthma type. These can be also managed. All the hyperactive child or the hypersensitivity reactions, that can be manageable. But if the maintaining cause is not there, I can give you a clue, the patient with syphilitic background, very strong syphilitic background, having asthma, bronchial asthma, will not suffer from bronchial asthma if he or she will go to very hilly region or very, usually whenever you are going through very hilly region, hill areas, their oxygen saturation is low. So there should be much more shortness of breath. But being a syphilitic background, the patient will not suffer from bronchial asthma. So it indicates that it is not the irreversible process. If you go through very good constitutional treatment and maintaining cause, if you maintain, then bronchial asthma can be cured. Bronchial asthma is not like that. It is the allergen. If you are exposed to allergen, then the allergic manifestation may occur. If you are not exposed to allergen, the manifestation will not occur.
Okay, sir. I think that your doubt would be clear. So one more doubt about the today's session, that Allen's keynote, that many of them asked that is Allen's keynote is sufficient to practice, or whether we have to refer any other kind of books?
No, never. I because what happened, H.C. Allen's keynote is wonderfully picked up one or two symptoms from herring, but it is very dangerous to the neonates of homeopaths or the very young homeopaths to practice based only on Allen's, because they must have some referral books, because these are the very short form of herring guiding symptom. You need not to go through the voluminous part of herring's guiding symptoms, symptomatology, but you can get the clues. But only depending on these, it is very dangerous one. Even the NASH leaders, NASH therapeutics, if you go through, one line is written, it is very dangerous to go through alone Allen. Even if you go through the Elizabeth Wright, the brief study course, wonderfully Elizabeth Wright said, he only based on Allen is very much risky. If the student has not the capability of knowing H.C. Allen, with the sound knowledge of clinical medicine and all other medical books. We should consult all others. But this book is very much used in West Bengal, but very less used in other parts. But it should be more used in other parts.
Yeah, that is true. Very well explained by you that it is very risky to use the Allen's keynote.
It is not told by me, it is also by Elizabeth Wright in Brief Study Course. You can find it.
Okay, sir. Sir, now I will ask Dr. S.P. Singh, sir, to continue.
ऐसा लगा आज के डॉक्टर रचन चट्टोपाध्याय जी ने दिल्ली से कलकत्ता तक शताब्दी ट्रेन की जो यात्रा कराई, इट वाज वंडरफुल रियली. इन द शॉर्ट टाइम एवरी मेडिसिन हैज एक्सप्लेन द लास्ट लाइन, यू नो, कॉन्स्टेंट कंपैरिजन एंड डिफरेंशिएशन इज मस्ट. व्हाटएवर यू हैव डिलीवर्ड इन अ लेक्चर, दैट वाज वंडरफुल. Student, if learn only 10% of your lecture, your guideline, that is must. But जैसे आपने कहा कि कलकत्ता में एलएस की नोट एंड थेरापेटिक्स, लेदर एंड थेरापेटिक्स, वैसे पूरे प्रांत में थ्रू आउट, नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया, एवरी वेयर इट शुड बी एलएस की नोट्स एंड लेदर एंड थेरापेटिक्स. यू नो, इट्स ए शॉर्ट लाइन आंसर. Guideline for prescribing in a brief, when lycopodium should be used, when Drasera used, how many dose you want to prescribe, when you will want to antidote, sometimes Cipersul, Merxol, whatever sulfur, calcareotide, lycopodium, everyone is prescribed. Without the proper guidelines, as mentioned in our Materia Medica, like Allen's keynotes, like leader and therapeutics, another Dr. N. M. Chaudhary, whatever various medicine doctrines he goes, comparative material medica, it is must to learn. And I think for every homeopath who want to learn some specific guideline for prescribing, a really homeopathic prescribing, it is must to learn. Dr. Rajat, sir, you have explained wonderfully. I would like to give thanks. Lot of thanks to you, and मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगा मेरे उन लाइकर्स को, लिसनर्स को, जिन्होंने बहुत ही गंभीरता से सुना. मटेरियल मेडिका समझना, ऑर्गनॉन समझना, इट्स नॉट अ वेरी इजी. अंटिल अनलेस यू विल नॉट कंसंट्रेट योर माइंड, योर बॉडी एट अ टाइम, यू विल नॉट एबल टू लर्न. लर्निंग इज पॉसिबल ओनली बाई कंसंट्रेशन, एंड दैट इज वाई यू जस्ट कंपेयर with other, just constant comparison and differentiation. Dr. Rajat Chattopadhyay jaise knowledge hai, to mere paas kyon nahi? Just compare with each and others, then you will be successful in life. Thank you to all audience, and thank you to Dr. Rajat Chattopadhyay, sir. Thank you, sir.